in Karnataka, the one and only Chief Minister, Devraj Aras. And I'm right now sitting near the statue of Devraj Aras. And here, he led a silent social revolution. That is his legacy. And he is the man who banned the night soil, took a lot of land reforms, and renamed the state name as Karnataka. During his tenure, a lot of reforms took up. And he, as being the chief minister, he always worked for the downtrodden class, and he also made an option for observing 16,000 people at the stretch, and they were later on they were given a permanent status. And Devraj Aras happens to be one of the greatest social reformer in the state, which Howard son. And regarding the land reforms, which he has spearheaded the movement, inspired everybody, a land for the tillers. Then again, he also, removed the bonded labor, and he worked for them, especially the bonded labor was highest in Mysore region. And Aras himself is remembered for his achievements in weaning away the poor people from the clutches of rich money lenders. And the chief minister also took a lot of initiative for the irrigation projects. So he was born in Kalahalli, that is at Hunsur Taluk, Mysore district. His father was also named Devraj Aras, and his mother was Deviri Ammani, and he got married at the very early age of 15 years. Then later on, he studied in a Aras boarding school in Mysore, and which the Mysore kings especially built in order to help their community people. In politics, see, in 1952, he contested the first elections, and he was there for 28 years long term. And later on, he set a record. Aras was a member of intra-party syndicate of powerful regional leaders, and he never antagonized towards the Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. Then, when we talk about his achievements as a chief minister for two terms, and he did excellently well. And this is in connection to the rediscovery of Vidhan Sauda, statues of Vidhan Sauda, part 3. This has been initiated by Srimati Vasanta Kavita, and the rediscovery of Vidhan Sauda. Inputs by Srimati Kavita, editor, Rajadharma, Mysore. This is Gyan Shekhar, parliamentary guy. Namaste. Once upon a time, a great leader, when he was in young days, when he went to the school, there were two parts. One was for untouchable and other was for touchables. But the moment he saw the part which was untouchable, he got resentment. And he totally broke down the part. And this really used much against the resentment, against the discrimination. I am right now sitting near the statue of Jagjivan Ram, who made a world record for 40 years of unstinted in parliamentary career. And this is being done by Srimati Vasanta Kavita under the rediscovery of Vidhan Sauda. Inputs from Kavita S, editor, Mysuru Rajadharma. Well, he started his career from the younger days, and he was quite active in the college also. And there also he protested against the discrimination. And in 1931, he joined the Indian National Congress. In 1928, he started the Mazdoor Rally. Then again, he participated very much in the relief work of the Nepal. But during that time, what happened? The Nepal was facing a lot of crisis. Then again, he protested against the discrimination being done by the upper caste regarding not entering to the wells as well as the temples. He made a movement, and even that also got succeeded. Likewise, he fought for the voting rights for the Dalits, Quit India movement, and not only that, he was twice jailed, and he was the youngest minister in Nehru cabinet, and he also implemented the labor laws, and he became a minister for many portfolios, and he left Congress in 1977. And later on, he formed alliances, and he served for, he formed a party called the Congress for Democracy. And when he formed the party, Congress for Democracy, and he was there for the 30 years, which happens to be one of the world record, where I am seeing the statue, and this statue is being in the prisonage of Vidhan Sauda. But why this statue has been installed is because he always fought for the cause of the Dalits, and this statue was inaugurated by H.D. Kumar Swami in 2007, October 2, if I am right. And this is around 13 feet high. That is the size of the feet. It is a bronze statue. And particularly during the significance of the statue is both on birthday as well as on the death day. The celebration will be done by the government. This is Gnan Shekhar. Namaste.
ಹೊಸ ಹೊಸ ವಿಡಿಯೋಗಳಿಗಾಗಿ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮತ್ತು ಬೆಲ್ ಬಟನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ.